Oh, this weather, eh? It's gone from bright sunshine all day and some to a wall of rain, darkness, cloud, cold curtains come down on life. We just had the Clegg on just the other day. I'm losing sleep. He made some lame jokes about, this time I've got some notes, while looking at the space. Yeah, he's made some lame jokes that deny us. He says, oh, it's real and takes a mickey out of people and collect this for me. But people haven't voted for a referendum on whether they want their bills to double. Let's put aside whether climate change is real or not. It's how to tackle it. Now, do people want to pay double bills or not? Do people want to go down these carbon tax rules and all the EU rules? People haven't had a say. They just say, oh, all they keep getting drummed in is like, climate change is real and it's man-made, climate change is real and it's man. Yeah, okay, let's put aside whether it is real or not. Let's say, now, how do you want to tackle that if you do believe? And there's no if, buts, and the maybes. It is real and it will be tackled like this, and we are the politicians and we will save you, and we will save you by doubling your bills. And they're saying that's for your own good. Oh, there are a lot of people doing it for your own good, isn't it? Well, it is real. We tell you it's real, so you better believe it's real, and we're going to brainwash you to make you believe it's real, and this is how your bills are going to go. And then, and the flip side is, when it all goes pear-shaped, they go, well, this is what the people wanted. When it all goes pear-shaped, this is what people wanted, this is what scientists told us. No one gets ends up with responsibility, no one goes to jail. Politicians just dodge, say, well, it's good for the people anyway, we needed to change our energy systems, and okay, some people end up dead. Stressed out, lower immune systems, the money could have been spent on hospitals, we didn't have to follow the EU's rush to gas or wind or all those panic alarmist measures that cost trillions out of the economy. All that money could have gone to hospitals. We didn't have to stress people's immune systems by doubling their bills, and people didn't have to freeze in winter. But no one is held responsible. No one goes to jail. Even bankers in this country don't go to jail. So everyone goes scot-free, and the policy says at the end of the day, it's what the people wanted. People believed it, not us. Nothing to do with us, mate. All hands up. All, you know, I was only doing what we thought was good. And you wanted it. You wanted your bills to double. Nothing to do with us, mate. So, they get off scot-free. All right, I better turn it off here. Okay, so Obama and Cameron were rushing into a war. Just going to make some more bombs and bang about a bit. And it's like, who? What Al-Qaeda? We're not helping Al-Qaeda. We're not creating a Al-Qaeda state. And in the Aleppo area of Syria, Azaz, the Al-Qaeda, or a group of them, or fractured, have overrun it. And they're going to try and cut off the area and take over the whole Aleppo area, that whole countryside, for Al-Qaeda, with the ambition of, and they've killed some normal rebel fighters, and the ambition of taking over the whole country, of making Al-Qaeda country, which then involves a big war, doesn't it? So, you know, with ground troops and all that. What? British and American ground troops, feet on the ground, to attack an Al-Qaeda country called Syria. And these are the people we're helping? It doesn't make sense. So, this is on the cards, this is a mess, and that's how that country's going to go. Syria's going to turn into an Al-Qaeda country, and we're going to have to end up with boots on the ground. And we're planning to help them. Mad. No, okay, so say, oh, you know, well, we don't take Al-Qaeda seriously, or you know, we don't believe this is real, or we don't even, you know, Al-Qaeda is not a serious threat. Well, what did you go for all these bloody wars around the other countries for, like Iraq and Afghanistan? What did we do all that for? What was all that for? Was that a joke? You know, you got Syria Al-Qaeda and Iraq and Afghanistan Al-Qaeda. I mean, you can't say one's real, one's a joke. No, 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 that was real times Al-Qaeda. These are joke Al-Qaeda, you know. Doesn't make sense. Bedroom tax. Latest stories out about bedroom tax is that, surprise, surprise, as there weren't the homes for the people to go into, a number of people being charged this bedroom tax. I'll be on with their rents now. Because their money was a shortfall, because it's taken straight out of their benefits. They say, this is enough for you to live on. But here's the bedroom tax, and we take it off you again. It's a funny thing about benefits in the UK. You get a certain amount, but if you go over that amount that's over a certain amount, it comes off you again in rent. Right. Weird. So, here's enough to live, what we agree, this is enough for what people to live on. Unless your rent is not even those high rents, it's just like a rent. Unless you're, you know, renting so much, and then, you know, we figure you have to pay some back. So, how those two weigh up, I don't know. This is enough for you to live on, here's your rent. And I don't know, man. Anyway, it turns out there wasn't the housing stock, which they knew all the time, available for people to move, to downsize to, the poor with the bedroom tax. And this has come as a great shock to people. Dun, dun, dun! Other shocking news. Did you know that 1 million people in this country could vote, who are not even British citizens? Did you know, because we're in the EU, we can't close the door? Did you know that because EU citizens are often desperate, they often get the first on the housing list and they get the places before everybody else? Because you're like, you never, you know, people wanting to leave their homes with nowhere to go, you know, like parents' homes. Of course, you've got these large families coming in from Europe. Straight away, they've got to be housed. I'm not sure how that works. There should be some sort of right housing rules where you have to be able to go to a job and have a home, rather than just like, as it is at the moment, you can work for a little while, then say, look, I've worked a little while, this is how I got in the country, now I'm homeless, I've got a big family, house me. This is how it works at the moment. Madness. Madness. And this is all the main three parties. I don't think any parties there. It's just absolute madness. Good luck.